calling. Okay, dear. Yes, in the last class we discussed about the loading, right?
Yeah.
And we have applied the dead load on our building.
Yes.
So first we applied the self load, self weight. So dear, any problem while applying the self weight to anyone? No.
Hello.
Yes.
We have to apply only one column for that building. The number of columns you have to multiply.
Sorry, Dinesh, I don't get you your question.
Sir.
Yes.
We have to multiply that dead load of column in that floor area or entire the building, or we can assume only one column it is load, dead load.
This is if you select the self weight,
yeah,
the structure is highlighted where the self weight is applied.
Okay.
So all the beams and members are highlighted.
Yeah.
It means this self weight is applied to our all structures.
Okay.
Now, if you click on this, right?
Okay.
So if you select this.
Okay.
If you see the load, UDL load, this is the UDL load, yes?
Yes.
And the UDL load C, which is applied on the all the members, on all the beams. Yes or no?
Yes.
Which is highlighted by the blue color.
Okay.
Right?
Right, right.
And now this is your floor load. So it means slab load, right?
Yeah.
And now the triangles are highlighted in the bottom.
Yeah.
With the blue color.
Okay.
It means this floor load is applied on the this first floor.
Yeah.
If you click on the second one, the second triangles is highlighted, right?
Yeah.
So can be this applied to the upper three also? Right?
Right, right.
Go to the front view and select this floor, this value, and apply it to you can change the Y range itself up to the 15.
Right.
And click on change. This is applied to all. See,
yeah,
I think dead load is clear, all of you.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yes.
If you have any type of doubt, then ask in the dead load.
Someone tell no, sir. Someone tell no.
Sorry?
Someone tell is no.
Is it not clear?
Yeah, yeah.
Who is?
I don't know, sir. My voice is clear.
Yes, sir, please repeat the...
Repeat again.
UDL load.
UDL.
Yes, how to apply that?
UDL.
Okay. MJ?
Yes.
Sorry. Is this question from MJ or Maxime?
MJ.
Okay. First, you have to create a UDL load in the dead load, right?
Yes.
So you can go to the dead load, right?
Yeah.
And click on add button. Yes.
Yes.
And go for the member load. And you can select the uniform force.
Yes.
Now here is the W1 value. You can specify, right?
Yes.
and this is your direction.
Yes.
And after that, you specify W1 value and D1, D2, and D3.
Sir, how do we find that W1 value? Please repeat that part again.
Okay. So you considered a UDL for the wall weight.
Yes.
Which is resting on the
beam.
Beam. So in the last class, you clearly said, you give the answer that how we find the weight of the wall. Yes or no?
Yes.
You give answer. We multiply the wall volume into
density of the concrete. Yes.
No. Density of the brick, not concrete here.
Yeah. Okay.
Because wall is made up of bricks. That's right.
Yes.
Yes, MJ?
Yes. Sir.
Yes.
So this is the value of W1. Right or wrong?
Yes.
And I give you the second method also. You can easily find the number of bricks in your wall.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So you can multiply the weight of one brick into the number of bricks.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So you will get the weight of wall in kg.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So can you able to convert into the Newton?
Yes.
So this is your W1.
Okay.
In Newton meter, right?
Okay.
Any other doubt? Any other doubt, dear?
No, sir.
Can we move forward?
Yes.
Okay. So this is your dead load on your building, right or wrong?
Hello.
Yes, Dinesh.
Hello, sir. We something. Now it is wall length is 3 meter.
Yes.
And height is something 3 meter.
Yes.
And opening is there to one meter by one meter opening is there. So this value will deduct on that applied on load or calculate entire wall.
Okay. Just wait. If we consider the whole wall. Yes. So it means you will consider for the maximum load.
Okay.
If you make a hole or any window on a wall, so it will be any effect on your member?
Yeah.
Member effect only when you increase the load.
Yeah.
If you decrease the load, it is the beneficial for your building?
No.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So that's why we not consider the dead type of objects.
Okay.
Because we not consider here the plaster weight, right?
Yeah.
And your mortar weight.
Yeah.
So you have to increase some weight for the plaster and mortar also.
Yeah.
Right. So if consider that if your load comes out the that's 100 Newton, right?
Yeah.
You can add a 50 Newton extra for your mortar weight and your plaster weight.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So there is no problem while in your question. Okay, dear?
Okay.
Any other doubt? Okay. Besides these loads, self-weight, uniform, and your linear bearing, right? Self-weight load and your wall load and your slab load. Any other load you want to consider for the structure? MJ?
Yes, sir.
So give the answer. If you want to consider any other load besides this?
Wind load.
No, no. In the dead load category only.
No more, sir.
Sure? Okay.
Yes.
Now you can close the dead load. Now? So now we are moving to the live load. Okay? Where you applied the live load?
Floor,
right?
Yes.
So you can apply a load on your walls, beam or column?
No.
Any live load applied on your beams?
No.
Yes. No. Okay. Very good. So, what was the live loads?
Furniture.
Yeah.
Man movement.
Yes. It means the live load may vary with the customer use.
Yeah.
Or customer purpose.
Yeah. So, and wind load. Wind load, sir. When rain is coming. Wind okay. load.
This is not a live load here. This is the different category.
Okay.
Wind load, right?
Yes.
Okay, we are talking about the live load. So, how you consider the live load?
The live load depends on the use of the unit.
Your voice is not clear here. Who is this?
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, I was saying that the live load depends on the use of the building.
Yes.
The purpose, yeah.
Okay, that's why I'm saying the live load is depend on your use.
Yes.
If this building is your hospital, right?
Yes.
So okay. your maximum load on your frame. How many people entered in a room at a time? Your floor area is 3x3.
Okay.
Minimum of 5.
Minimum you have saved the only 6 beds, right?
Yes.
And 6 men, if you consider the 1 or 2 attendant at a time for the one patient, 2 plus 6 is a 12 and 18. 18 people, and you consider 2 as your warden, right? Nurses, yes. And your attendant, right?
Yes.
So almost 20 persons in a room, right? Maximum. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Now.
But sir.
Sorry.
Yeah, we talk about safety factor of safety.
Your voice is not clear, dear. Or go to the load case detail and click on the add, right? This time we clicking on the selecting the load case detail because we are taking the another load case as live load. Yes, dear.
Yes.
So click on the add. Now here you can consider as the
live
load and give the name as live, right? Clicking on the add, right? And close. So this is your live load box, right? Now you can click here and click on add. So as we discuss, the load of building is depend on uses. Okay, if this is the commercial building, okay, so we don't know the how much load can user can apply on the each floor. HV, it means each floor may we have the different loads. Yes or no?
Yes.
So aap kya karenge? So what you want to do? So you can create a live or different live load for the different floors also. Yes or no?
Yes.
So this load you can click on select the live load, click on edit. So give the name as this is your first floor, right?
Yes.
And change. And you create the another one. This is your live two, right?
Yes.
Live three. If you want to apply the same load, you can only consider the one. Okay.
Yes.
Four. And this is your live five. Yes.
Yes.
So we have the five floors, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 now. So let us decide the load for the first floor. So give the value. Yes, give the value. First of all, tell me, this is your commercial, you consider as a commercial or a residential?
Commercial.
Okay. On the first floor, you can assume that a teaching institute is there. Right here?
Yes.
Okay. So at a time, maybe a teaching institute have a maximum strength in a class is 60. Okay.
Yes.
So you consider the average weight of each student is 65. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
So it means 60 into 65 is the total weight of your students. Yes.
Yes.
And you consider a 75 kg of your teacher weight. So please calculate how much the total.
Three thousand nine hundred seventy kg.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And now, on the inspection time, your classroom is full. Okay.
Yes.
And extra 3 or 4 persons is coming with the inspector, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So it means you add 4 members extra, right?
Divide
to 4. The average weight is 70. So you can add a 280 kg, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Sometimes on the festival occasions, absentees are more, right?
Yes.
If one faculty is absent, right?
Yes.
And now the responsibility for the one faculty to take the 2 classes.
Yes.
So it is not possible to take in different classes, right? So he can merge the both the classes in the one class, right?
Yes.
So if we are considering that the total number of students is 100, but on the average basis, the average student is 60. But this is India, dear. So everyone want the. This is possible to merge the classes in one class only. It happens. In our time, it also happens, right or wrong?
Yes.
So you can consider the average student as 100. So you can go for the maximum load, not the minimum. This is my point. Whether it is applied in the once in a year or two times in a year, right? But yes. It can be applied, yes or no?
Yes.
That's why we are going for the maximum. So dear, tell me, what was the total load?
Rest students 85 kg, 6855 total that.
Okay, this is in the kg, right?
Yeah.
Can you convert it into the newton?
Yeah.
And how much newton is there?
8.55.
58.55
kN.
In newton or kilonewton?
Kilonewton.
Okay. So go for the live load, click on the add, or you can go to the flow load, right?
Yes.
And give here as the minus how much? 68, right? Yes. First of all, you have to change the unit in the kilonewton, right? This is your input unit, right? So, but this is message on input unit change is not allowed while the adding or editing the load, right? So you have to click on the any other and go to the and you will click on the kilonewton, right? Okay, now again go to the general loading. This is your load tab. Now here member load, sorry, flow load. And tab is minus 58, right?
68.
68 or 58?
68.
Okay. 68. Give the Y range 0 to 3, which is for the first flow, right?
Yeah.
12 and 12. 15. Click on. Sorry.
Okay.
Hello.
We taken height as for 15 meter, sir.
Here we consider for the each floor.
Okay.
So that's why height is 0 to 3. Okay. Is considered only one floor, right?
Okay.
Okay. Now this is adding on the. But this is the very high load here. Your calculation, you've done a calculate mistake. It may be a 6.8 in kilonewton.
Yeah, 6.8. Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. You can. What was the value for the second flow? You give the approximate here. You consider as the 7? Yes. You can give the 7 kilonewton for the second floor.
Yes.
And you consider the 5, minimum range is 5 and maximum is 6, right?
Yes.
And give 12 and 12, right?
Yes.
And click on add button. So this is your second floor load. For the third floor, you can give add button and go to the floor load. And you considered as the third floor as minus 8, right?
Yes.
And this is how much? 8 to 9.
Six.
6 is the second floor. This is the for third floor here.
Okay.
12 and 12, right?
Yes.
Okay. For the fourth floor, how much? 6.5 minus 6.5, right? And this is minimum is 11. And this is your 12, right? And this is your 12. And this is also 12, right?
Yes.
Click on add. This is your live pipe, add flow load. And give the value as minus 7.5. Yes, dear? And the final value is 14, 15, 12, and this is also a 12, right? So we can apply it on all the floors as lab load, different lab loads. Okay.
So we are not adding on that furniture load, sir.
So we considered the furniture also dear in the 100 students.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So if you want to increase, you can increase 1 kiloton. Okay. This is you can apply 7.8 kiloton for the 1 meter square area only. Okay. Right, dear?
Right.
Okay. So this is your the different loads, right?
Yes.
Now, if you do analysis, it will give you the result on dead load separately for the first load, second load, live load, third load, live load. But these loads are acting on a building at a time, not at a time. You have to create a combination of these loads, right or wrong?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So you have to create a combination with the live loads. Yes or no? Yes. First combination of dead load and the first live load. Dead load and the second live load. Right or wrong?
Yes.
Dead load and the third live load.
Yes.
So you have to go to the load case. Click on the add button and go to the defined combination, right?
Yes.
And now here you have to give the safety of factor as 1.5. Yes. Now you can select the dead load and the live load and shift here. This is your combination number 1. Change the name.
Okay.
And click on the add. Combination is added here.
Yes.
Okay. Now choose combination number 2 for the dead load and the live 2. And click on the add button. Similarly, you can give for 3 also, dead and live 3. And add. 4. Dead and live 4. Add. 5. Dead and live 4. 5, sorry. Right?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes. Okay.
So this is your live load and your dead load. Right?
Yes.
Now you analyze the building. Yes?
Yes.
You go to the analysis and print.
Yes.
And go to the check the all and click on the add. And click on close. This is the compulsory step. If you forget this step, the analysis is not possible.
Okay. Repeat again the step.
Go to the analysis and print, click on all,
okay.
Check the all and click on the add button, right?
Okay.
So this is the perform analysis print.
Okay.
Right?
Where now, will we got this result, sir?
Where you give, find the result.
Yeah, where will we get this result?
Okay. First, you analyze your building here.
Okay.
Go to the analyze button. Okay. Click on and the run analysis. The shortcut key is Ctrl plus F5. And click on yes button. A window is coming.
Okay.
You will see the stat analysis and design.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So you have to see the zero error, zero warning. It means we have applied all the things in the systematic way or in the syntax of this dead load.
Yes.
You don't do any mistakes. If you find the error,
we done mistakes on the map.
Yes. You cannot forward without resolving the errors. Right? If you find the warning, it means it is considerable. Okay?
Yeah.
It is considerable.
Yes.
Or if you find the error, which is not considerable.
Yes.
You have to go to the view output function.
Okay.
And the second option is go to the post-processing mode. So after that, we go from this tab, post-processing, right?
Okay.
Now we want the output file. Click on the done. The total pages in the report is
210.
First of all, this is your about the software, time, date,
name,
right?
Date.
And this is the file name, right? Date, job, and this is your the units, meter and newton, right? So in the row 8, this is the 1. This is the node 1. Okay? And 0, 0 is the coordinate of node 1. This is the 2, node 2. 3, 0, 0 is the
coordinates of node 2.
Yes, this is 3 node, this is 4 node, this is 5 node, 6 node, and all the relative coordinates for the particular node, which is separated by the semicolons. Right?
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, after the 210, repeat the step, sir. Page number after you tell 210. Repeat that.
Okay. So we directly go to the row number 8. Right?
No, no.
Okay, yes.
Hello. हम लोग डिस्कस कर रहे थे सर, वो सामने का नेम प्लेट आया उसके बाद डिस्कस कर रहे.
अच्छा, दिस इज द नेम प्लेट, राइट? दिस इज द ओनली अबाउट द सॉफ्टवेयर, बैटरी, डेट एंड टाइम, राइट?
ओह या.
एंड दिस इज द फाइल नेम, राइट?
ओके.
डेट,
ओके.
जॉब एंड इंफॉर्मेशन, इनपुट बिट, एंड दिस इज योर यूनिट, राइट?
या.
एंड दिस इज योर जॉइंट कोऑर्डिनेट.
यस.
सो दिस इज योर वन node, and this is your coordinate, node 2 coordinate, node 3 coordinate, node 4 coordinate, node 5 coordinate, right?
Yes, that's right.
Right. Similarly, you find total number node is 150. And what is the coordinate of the last node? 12, 15 and 12. Okay?
Yes.
Now second is member indices. Member indices means this is your beam number 1, which is connected to the node number 6 and 7. Beam number 2, which is connected to 7 and 8 node. Beam number 3, which is connected to node number 8 and 9. Okay? Similarly, you can find how many members are there? 325 members. Yes.
Yeah.
And yes. What is the node to connect the node number beam number 325? 120 and
150.
This is your material. After that, you create the geometry. You have assigned the material. So the material is concrete, and this is the value for your material.
Okay.
Now, in the last. The material defined is end, and defined material here.
Yes.
Now, in the next step, we have assigned the property, right? Member property.
Yes.
So 1 to 20 and 46 to 65, this is the member numbers.
Yes.
You assign the 04 in YD and 03 in the ZD. Right? Similarly, you can 0.45 YD and ZD for these members, right?
Yes.
And this is your support on which nodes you applied the fixed support. First is the dead load, self weight, member load. This is your flow load, right?
Yes.
After that, you have by the Y range. Load 2 is live, and this is your, you change the unit into meter to kilonewton here, right? After yes. the flow load for the 6.8,
yes.
7, 8, yes. 6.5, yes. and 7.5, right? After that, you create a combination with a factor of 1.5, right?
Sure.
After that, you will for the perform analysis sprint. Yes, remember?
Yes.
So, up to here, you give the input. This is your description of your input data. Okay. Now, after that, this is your output after the analyzing. This is your how many joint you have? 150. How many numbers you have, members you have? 325. Number of supports, 25. And this is your load type. And this is your what? Your actual weight of the structure. Okay, dear?
Yes.
This is your actual weight of structure. And this is your UDLs, right?
Yes.
And each and every point you have defined the UDL. So this is your flow load here. You see, you will consider the member. So this is your member load, right? This is your member load, which is the flow load, right? Which is apply on the flow load, right?
Yes.
You can see the this is the concentrated load value in the linear bearing. Your load in the triangular in shape, dear?
Yes.
So on the length 0.12, this is the value. In the 0.29, this is the value. In the 0.47, this is the value. On, consider only with the member number one, right?
Okay.
And the your concentrated load value is gradually increasing, right?
Yeah.
So in the middle, 1.41 and 1.59, the value is same. After that, the value is decreasing according to the length.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
After that, the another member is started. Similarly,
okay.
So we have 325 members for the okay. description like this.
Okay.
Okay. So
okay.
We don't have any information about the bending movement and shear force, right?
Yeah.
Now we have to close this window and now click on the post-processing mode. Yes? So, first we talk about the node, right?
Right.
So, this is the node 1, right?
Yeah.
And we have applied the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 loads, right? So, this yeah. will give the displacement of node 1 with respect to these nodes, right?
Right.
For the node number 2, node number 3, node number 5, 6, 7, 8, each and every value is there. If the displacement is negative, it will define in the negative. If the displacement is positive, it okay. gives the value as
positive,
right? If you want a summary, the maximum displacement of the maximum node. You have the maximum displacement. You can click on the summary. So we have the 10 nodes which have maximum displacement, right? So this is the displacement about the nodes, okay, with respect to each node. This is the nodes you can see here, right? Now we are talking about the beam. So this is your beam number one, which is highlighted by the red color. The force on kilonewton in Fx, Fy, Fz, Mx, My, and Mz with respect to dead load.
Dead load.
With respect to
live load.
Live load 2, live load 3, 4, right? Which is maximum by the live load first, because we applied here, right?
Yes.
Similarly, you can see each and every beam with the values. If you want the summary, you can click on the summary button. So this is the maximum
value.
10 numbers, 10 beams, which have the maximum number of
values.
Forces.
Force and moment.
No, only the force.
Yeah.
This is a beam and forces. Clear? Okay.
Yes.
Now in the second window,
yes,
we have the bending moment. This tab is provide you the bending moment, whether it is maximum or, whether it is in negative or positive bending moment, right?
All node points or?
Bending moments is considered only on the beams here, not the
nodes. All beams? Sir?
Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, each and everything, right?
Okay.
This is your shear force here.
Okay.
For each and every member. Okay.
Yes.
Now, if you want the BFD and SFD, bending moment diagram and the shear force diagram, you can just click on any member, right? Yes. So you have the geometry. It means it have the beam number one. This is your section property, right?
Yes.
This is your depth of your beam. Go to the property. This is your property, right?
Yes.
Go to the loading. This is the load type on this member. Go to the shear and bending. So, dear, this is your bending moment diagram. By which load?
Dead load one.
You there?
Only dead load.
Dead load.
If you select the live load first, this is your bending moment according to
first live load.
Yes. Select the two. There is a minimum for the live load two, because this is applied on the second floor. The maximum value or real value is coming from the combination one. Yes or no?
Yes.
So see. This is the maximum value for the bending moment. And now you want to shear force, you can click on the shear. So this is your shear force. Yes or no?
Yes.
So you can, if you want to see the deflection, this is your deflection in the y direction. The maximum deflection is occur at 1.750. This is the maximum. Okay?
Yes.
So you can check for each and every number.
Okay.
Right, dear?
Right.
Yes. If you have the bending moment diagrams for this, so you can see here. This is the graphs for members, right? You can see here. click on animation, you want to check the deflection, you check. There is no deflection in the building. We have here we have the deflection. See.
Yeah.
On the roof. So this is the analysis process here up to this. Right?
Yes.